Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Vasant Kumar L. from Mysore Medical College and Research Institute. Today, I'm going to present my paper on evaluation of interstitial lung disease by high-resolution computed tomography of chest. Coming on to introduction, interstitial lung disease or heterogeneous group of disorder characterized by bilateral, often patchy pulmonary fibrosis, mainly affecting the wall of alveoli with diffuse abnormality on lung radiograph. On HSCT of the thorax, it is one of the standard diagnostic tests for ILD, which is used to see the fine details of interstitium, which may or may not be visible on chest radiograph. And it has been coming onto the specific diagnosis so that further testing, which are invasive like bronchoscopy or surgical lung biopsy, is not required. So coming onto the objectives, the main objectives is to evaluate the interstitial lung disease in symptomatic patient with normal or equivocal chest radiograph. To accurately assess the pattern of distribution and severity of the disease process for the purpose of treatment and management. Coming on to the etiology, it can be because of drug induced like antibiotic or antiarrhythmic drug, can be because of connective tissue disorder like scleroderma, SLE, rheumatoid arthritis. Can also be because of a certain inhaled agent. It can be organic or inorganic, like silica, asbestos, foam antigens. Other conditions like infectious, malignant condition like bronchoalveolar carcinoma can also cause this condition. Coming on to materials and method, all the patients with clinical suspicions of interstitial lung disease who have been referred to our department have been subjected to HRCT. It was an hospital-based cross-sectional study conducted for a period of 18 months. So coming on to a few of the representative cases, the first case is an unusual interstitial pneumonia. The classical HRCT findings in unusual interstitial pneumonia are presence of reticular opacity with honeycombing and with or without traction bronchiectasis. All this should be subpleural and basal predominance. This is a case of usual interstitial pneumonia. We can see the presence of honeycombing with extensive reticular opacity, which is subpleural and basal predominance, which usually present in UIP pattern. The second case is an acute interstitial pneumonia. In acute interstitial pneumonia, it is a fulminant form, usually causes like diffuse alveolar damage, usually in a previous healthy individual. The classical HRCT findings will be patchy bilateral groundless opacity with consolidation, which is predominantly in the posterior segments of the lung. There can be architectural distortion, traction bronchiectasis, or honeycombing as the disease progresses. The first set of image is a case of AIP. We can see patchy groundless opacity with interlobar septal thickening involving bilateral lung lobes with traction bronchiectasis. The next is a respiratory bronchiolitis associated interstitial lung disease. This disease is mainly associated with smokers, and it is characterized by macrophage accumulation within the bronchial and alveolar wall. On HRCT, we can see ground glass opacity, centrilobular nodules. In advanced cases, we can also see fibrotic changes. Other changes related to smoking, such as bronchial wall thickening and centrilobular nodules, can be seen. In the second set of image, we can see the presence of diffuse ground glass opacity with patchy areas of hair trapping and diffuse emphysematous changes with mediastinal lymphadenopathy. This is a case of respiratory bronchiolitis into ILD. Next is a non-specific interstitial lung disease. Here, the HRCT will going to have various combination of ground glass opacity, consolidation, reticular opacity, traction bronchiectasis, etc. Honeycombing may be present, but it is very slight. One of the classical features is subpleural sparing of changes within the lung parenchyma. The first set of image is an NSIP. Is a condition of NSIP. We can see interlobar septal thickening with ground glass opacity and subpleural sparing involving bilateral lower lung lobes. Next is in a lymphoid interstitial pneumonia. Here there will be diffuse T cell infiltration. On HRCT, we can see thickening of bronchovascular bundles along with interstitial thickening, pulmonary nodules. We can see thin wall cyst with ground glass opacity. In this second set of image, which is a lymphoid interstitial pneumonia, we can see numerous thin-walled, well-defined cysts, which are randomly distributed. And also there is presence of ground glass opacity with nodules. So coming on to results and interpretation, we included about 50 patients in our study. And the age group ranges from 60 to 69 years. Majority of the patients were housewife and farmer by occupation. About 36% were smoker. About 10% were exposed to grain test and bird and animal droppings. In HRCT, we can see features like interlobar septal thinking, reticulation, fibrotic changes, traction bronchiectasis, honeycombing, and ground glass opacities. So on coming on to discussion, interstitial lung disease, diverse group of parenchyma lung disease, having varying significantly in etiology, pathogenesis, and histopathology. HRCT remains a standard for precise diagnosis in symptomatic patient, particularly if the clinical diagnosis remains unclear. In the present study, the patient mostly included between 60 to 69 years with the female predominance, and there was significant history of smoking. So the common diagnosis in our study was usual interstitial pneumonia, NSIP, acute interstitial pneumonia, lymphoid interstitial pneumonia, and respiratory bronchiolitis, ILD. The observation in our study was incomparable with other studies, like studies done by Patel BB et al, Mohammed SK et al. In all these studies, the usual interstitial pneumonia was the most common, followed by NSIP and EIP. Concluding, ILD is a disease of middle age group with a female predominance. HRCT is a preferred technique to study the lung parenchyma, which precisely demonstrated the pattern, distribution, and extent of the ILD. HRCT reduces the need for confirmatory lung biopsy, even though when HRCT findings are equivocal, it can guide for accurate lung biopsy sites, so complication can be prevented. Thank you. These are my references. Thank you.